It's an age-old question. Ibuprofen or acetaminophen? And what's the difference anyways? Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. I got a migraine recently and I popped a few ibuprofen and felt so much better. But that made me wonder, how do major pain relievers actually reduce pain? Well, there are special receptors in your body that respond specifically to pain called nociceptors. They protect us by responding to potentially damaging stimuli like a burn or a cut and send a signal fast to the brain. Once your brain gets the signal, ouch, this hurts, your body is already going to work to heal the wound. Most injuries get hot and swollen, but this is your body trying to protect itself. By swelling, the body might prevent further injury by immobilizing, say, a joint or whatever, and the heat might be the result of increased blood flow or might cause increased blood flow, which means more healing immune cells get to the point of injury. Another thing injured cells release is arachidonic acid. The two enzymes, COX-1 and COX-2, react with this acid to produce prostaglandins. These can create other chemicals which are responsible for all that swelling, heat, and pain. And this seems to be the target mechanism of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs like ibuprofen. Ibuprofen was discovered in the 1960s and in 1983 was made available over the counter. It's originally designed to be an anti-inflammatory drug. It works by stopping the production of prostaglandins by blocking one of the active sites of COX-1 and COX-2. When ibuprofen is in the active site, arachidonic acid can't fit, so prostaglandins can't be made and thus the heat and pain-causing swelling is reduced. Acetaminophen, on the other hand, isn't an anti-inflammatory drug. How it works? Well, that gets a little complicated. It was first discovered in the late 1800s and really didn't reach the market until 1955 when it was marketed as Tylenol. And really, nobody's quite sure how it works. I'm not kidding, there are a lot of ideas, but nothing conclusive yet. In 2002, scientists in England discovered another COX enzyme and they labeled it COX-3. This new enzyme can be found mostly in the brain, and it seems more sensitive to acetaminophen than other anti-pain medications. But unfortunately, this only seemed true in tests with other animals. Another idea is that acetaminophen works differently on COX enzymes than ibuprofen. COX enzymes have two active sites, one that arachidonic acid binds with, and another, the peroxidase side, which leads to the production of a tyrosine radical. It's this other active site that acetaminophen might bind with, preventing the body from making this compound, relieving some pain. Or another idea, and this one is my personal favorite. Researchers from Lund University in Sweden think acetaminophen actually works on the endocannabinoid system. If that word sounds a little familiar to you, yes, it's the system that responds to cannabis or weed. But it's also involved in a lot of different processes like appetite, pain sensation, mood, and memory. So the researchers claim that acetaminophen activates two ion channels in the brain and spinal cord and that these channels also respond to certain cannabinoids. But the researchers caution that these channels can actually trigger pain and itch responses. So it seems odd that activating them reduces pain. But they might be onto something. Another study published in the European Journal of Pharmacology shows that blocking cannabinoid receptor type 1 prevents acetaminophen from relieving pain in mice. But there's a few other ideas of how the drug works, like maybe it works on serotonin receptors, but who really knows right now? So even for a drug as old as acetaminophen, it's clear more research is needed. All right guys, the real question is, are you a fan of ibuprofen or acetaminophen? Does one work better for you than the other? Let us know down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews. We've got new episodes every day of the week.